Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I cordially welcome all of you to our presentation on IEEE Region 10 Symposium 2020. The coronavirus disease outbreak has created a global health crisis that has had a deep impact on the way we perceive our world and our everything lives. Hope all the participants, the delegates, and the respectable professors are safe and sound during this critical situation. Considering the safety of all participants and our community during this COVID-19 pandemic, this most prestigious flagship technical conference of IEEE Region 10 has moved to full virtual conference. So we are grateful to the conference committee for considering this critical situation. Now let's discuss our presentation. The title of our paper is Vibration Measurement and Analysis Using Arduino-Based Accelerometer. Myself, MD Hasibuzzaman, and the other fellow authors are Abu Sufyan, Rubayat Kobir Shefa, Raihan Rifat, Joy Ghosh, and Abhijit Sharkar. And we are the student of Department of Electrical and Electronic Engineering of American International University, Bangladesh. Now a quick look at our presentation outline. First, let's talk about the goal of our proposed model. The main goals are to design of a vibration meter, to design and implement vibration meter using ADXL345 accelerometer, to transfer data using Wi-Fi module, to observe data in mobile phone and in computer server, to find the accuracy of the device and compare the data with standard vibrometer. Now first we have to know why we chose this topic. One of the main causes of structural damage to the building is vibration. By detecting early vibration through digital technology, many losses and accidents can be reduced. The design prototype shows the implementation process of the ADXL345 accelerometer and Arduino-based vibration analysis. The prototype consists of ADXL345 accelerometer Arduino Mega Wi-Fi module. It performs the following functions like measuring vibration and also analyzing the overall vibration as well as compare with the standard device from the correctness side. The resultant data can be transmitted on a personal server, which is a very helpful way. This work gives focus to show the causes of vibration controlling and to find the impulse movement of the proper specification and of machinery situation and how much it affects the structure. So to maintain the machinery, vibration observing is a much needed part of this established area. These are the equipment we use to make our project successful. In the slide, the methodology and designing of proposed model are discussed. In figure 3, this is the block diagram of the basic system of our proposed model. The hardware is designed with an ADXL345 accelerometer that will measure the vibration coming from different types of vibrating object. The accelerometer is connected with Arduino and Arduino will receive the data and finally by serial communication the data will send to the server by ESP8266 NodeMCU. In figure 4, this is the flowchart of ADXL345 data sensing operation. If vibration is occurred and the data is sensed by ADXL345, then the data is collected by a microcontroller and then sent it to a laptop or server. Here demonstrated in figure 5 the flowchart of BlinkApp data analysis process. BlinkApp is an IoT stage which can control, monitor in a process, interact with IoT device. BlinkApp will receive data only when Wi-Fi mode is connected and the hardware will constantly send the data. In figure 6, the flowchart of the ThingSpeak data analysis process is given. ThingSpeak is an IoT based stage on server which is almost similar as MATLAB analysis process. It is an open source web service that stores data and sends data and helps to present the data in a digital graphical way. In ThingSpeak data storing and analysis process, the data will send only when Wi-Fi is connected, then it constantly sends the data and makes autocorrect to the ThingSpeak data field. In the slide, the equation for acceleration and frequency analysis, circuit diagram and link data analysis process are given. Two types of acceleration can be measured. One is linear acceleration and another is angular acceleration. Here the acceleration and centrifugal acceleration equations are given. Now the circuit diagram of our proposed model. In figure 7, the proper implementation method of ADXL345 accelerometer and the connection between Arduino and ADXL345 is given. The model is formatted on a surface that has 3.3 volt observance and 3 axis because of increasing the accuracy in comparison of traditional 1 axis accelerometer. The ADXL345 detects the data and a microcontroller Arduino will receive the data and sends by accelerometer and by serial communication the data will send to server by ESP8266 NodeMCU. Now Blink data analysis process. It is very easy to set up Blink app process to get the data. Blink app must be downloaded and placed on the mobile phone. Then that Then it is needed to select a new project of ESP8266. After creating the new project, then select the value display from the wedge box. For showing the 3-axis data, it is also needed to select 3 value display. Then connect both ESP8266 Wi-Fi module as well as mobile phone in the same network. In order to connect Blink app in the hardware, an author token is given over mail. This is how Blink app is developed for showing data and storing data in mobile phone. Now ThingSpeak data analysis process. At first, it is needed to create a ThingSpeak account through email. Data collection process has been done by creating a private channel, and data will share by the creating the public channel. This server helps to analyze and visualize the sensor data with MATLAB. Hardware implementation comes after seeing the successful software simulation. In figure 10, the experimental setup for Arduino ADXL345 and NodeMCU are shown. Now the experimental process of data sending to Blink app. The ESP8266 NodeMCU send the acceleration data for X, Y and Z axis to the Blink app. By wireless connection, the NodeMCU send the data to the Blink app in the mobile phone. In figure 11, the acceleration and frequency data of a car engine is sent to the Blink app is shown. Now the experimental process of data sending to ThingSpeak server. The data is collected from accelerometer which is sent to NodeMCU via Arduino, and with the help of NodeMCU, the data is sent to the ThingSpeak server. The server takes the data and plotting curve with a delay of 30 seconds. Figure 12 shows the data storing and graph plotting in ThingSpeak. Now the experimental result analysis for Blink data. These are the graph for acceleration versus time graph, where x-axis is for acceleration and y-axis for time. The highest amplitude for x-axis is 9.16 meter per second square, for y-axis 6.58 meter per second square, and for z-axis 19.32 meter per second square. Figure 14 shows the frequency data plotting of x and y-axis. The highest frequency magnitude of x and y-axis is about 15 Hz. From the amplitude value of the graph, the condition of the engine is analyzed. For acceleration in x-axis, the highest peak value is almost 10, and for the same value of the magnitude is slightly greater than 15. The experimental engine which we use for data measuring has the highest frequency is 33.6 Hz. The highest frequency tolerating value of the engine is 1 kHz, so it can be said that the engine is totally in good condition because its vibrating frequency is less than its highest frequency tolerating value. Figure 15 shows the acceleration and frequency data for vibrometer. The average frequency for x-axis is about 15 Hz. On the other hand, for vibrometer, the average frequency for vibrometer is about 10 to 15 Hz. From the picture, it is seen that the data for vibrometer is 4.9 Hz, and at the same time, the accelerometer data for x-axis is 4.37 Hz. Now let's discuss the comparison of vibration meter made with accelerometer and vibrometer VM6360. The frequency sensing level of our vibration meter is 3020 Hz. On the other hand, the frequency level is about 10 Hz to 1 kHz for VM6360. The accuracy of our vibration meter is plus minus 4.5%. On the other hand, the accuracy level of vibrometer VM6360 is near to plus minus 5%. The sensor can measure the value without any physical touch in our vibrometer. A built-in sensor is inside the vibrometer which sends the vibration frequency. With the help of Wi-Fi module, the resultant value can be observed for away from the experimental area in our vibration meter. There is no data transferring module in VM6360. Data transferring rate is so fast in our vibration meter. There is no option to transfer data in vibrometer VM6360. In our vibration meter, the weight is low due to the being small size. On the other hand, the weight is low but comparatively higher than accelerometer. There is no use of probes in our vibration meter. On the other hand, there is a use of probe in vibrometer VM6360 for collecting data. Now a quick look of components used to design the proposed model. To design the proposed model, our total cost was approximately $57. Everything has its limitation in our project. The hardware casing is not satisfactory because the sensor is totally in open environment and the circuit is implemented in Vero board. On the other hand, the traditional vibrometer available in the market has a small and standard casing and for operating some buttons there. But we cannot do proper casing for ADXL and Arduino due to the shortage of time. As I discuss, everything has its limitations, but they are always look for improvement. The future scopes are to find more developed method, and it is better to use GSM module instead of Wi-Fi module. The sensor data can be analyzed by plotting card by in MATLAB software. For industrial purpose, PCB board is the best choice because PCB design makes the circuit smaller. For decreasing the delay of programming, Raspberry Pi instead of Arduino Mega can be used, which helps to increase the speed of data transfer in the server. It could be more effective to analyze data through LabVIEW. Now, conclusion. In final, it can be said that the proposed model is beneficial for its proper measurement, and it is also a developed model for finding mechanical acceleration vibration, which is much more efficient for safety purpose. This is the basic idea of finding proper data by accelerometer. It provides data with a minimum amount of error and provides some advanced facilities that other available devices cannot. With wireless data transfer system, it has ensured its safety purpose more strongly. It is also cheaper than other available measuring devices in the market. With a proper recharge, it can be updated more. Here are the references we used. And that concludes our presentation. Please stay home to combat the spread of COVID-19 and stay safe. Thank you very much.